What's up guys, this is Mike again with ECS Tuning, and today we're going to show you some diverter valve and blowout valve options we offer for your 2.0T. Four of the options we have include an upgraded piston diverter valve, a forge atmospheric blowout valve adapter, a forge upgraded diverter valve kit, and a forge blowout valve kit. When Volkswagen first introduced their 2-liter turbo engine, their diverter valve design consisted of all plastic internals and a fragile rubber membrane. Even under stock boost, this membrane has been known to tear and create a leaking diverter valve. After going back to the drawing board, Volkswagen introduced their new upgraded piston diverter valve. This valve eliminates the fragile rubber membrane and upgrades the internals from plastic to metal, giving you more peace of mind, especially when running overstock boost levels. What we have here is a 2010 Volkswagen Mark 6 GTI with the Golf R diverter valve relocation kit. And now I'm going to show you how easy it is to install the upgraded OEM diverter valve. Start by simply removing the 3 Allen bolts that are holding the diverter valve in place. After doing this, simply lift up the diverter valve. Carefully remove all of your Allen head bolts and undo the connector by prying down on the tab and pulling outward. Now, take your upgraded piston diverter valve, position it in place, reinsert your 3 Allen head bolts, and tighten the valve down securely. After doing that, reinstall your diverter valve connector plug. Now, one of the best things about this valve is that it won't give you a check engine light or void your manufacturer's warranty. The next option we had for you was the Forge blowout valve adapter. What this adapter does is allow you to turn any OEM diverter valve into a blowout valve. This simple installation only requires a few things. First, start off by removing the 3 Allen head bolts that secure the diverter valve in place. Next, lift up on the diverter valve and insert the forged blowout valve adapter. Replace your diverter valve onto the forged blowout valve adapter and secure it with the 3 Allen head bolts that came with the adapter kit. Make sure the bolts are tightly secured to avoid any leaks. What Forge has done with their adapter is block off any air from getting into the recirculation hose and force it to vent to atmosphere. Now we're going to move on to Forge's diverter valve kit. This kit comes with all the necessary install parts as well as install instructions. What Forge has done is include an intake manifold vacuum block and allow you to use a vacuum solenoid to control the valve, as well as connect to your stock connector to avoid a check engine light. This diverter valve also comes with different tension springs depending on what type of boost you're running. This vacuum block has a possible 3 outlets, so you can reference pressure for your blowout valve, diverter valve, or for other things such as gauges. Our pre-configured setup today includes 1 vacuum nipple and 2 vacuum blocks. To install the vacuum block, pull on the intake manifold hose and pry on these tabs to allow it to slide off. Once the hose has slid off, install the vacuum block, firmly pressing it towards the intake manifold, and install the retaining clip that Forge has provided with their kit. Once this clip slides in, the vacuum block is secured. Now, reinstall the intake manifold hose. Now we're going to assemble the diverter valve. Out of the 2 springs, we've chosen the yellow one for running higher boost. Now, you're ready to screw on the top of the valve. Once secured, you're ready to install it on the car. Now, position the valve onto the flange and install two of the securing Allen heads. Depending on your preference, the vacuum block mount can be mounted on either side of the valve. For our use, we've chosen to mount it towards the intake. The vacuum block mount is held in place by one of the securing Allen heads from your OEM valve. Next, make sure the bolts are tight to avoid boost leaks. Remember to position the vacuum block mount whichever way you want it before tightening the bolt. Now, it's time to install your vacuum solenoid. For an easier installation, before securing down the vacuum solenoid, run a piece of vacuum hose from the metal end of the solenoid to the bottom nipple of the diverter valve. Make sure both ends are secured before proceeding any further. After the hose is secured, tighten down your vacuum solenoid. Make sure not to over-tighten the bolts so you don't crack the plastic. Now, run a line from the bottom of the vacuum solenoid to the nipple on the vacuum block. Our last piece of vacuum hose needs to be ran from the top of the diverter valve to the top of the vacuum solenoid. Now, attach the wire that came with your kit to the vacuum solenoid and connect it to your OEM harness. The last of four options we have for you today is the Forge blowout valve kit. Just like the diverter valve kit, they have used a vacuum solenoid and an adapter harness to prevent a check engine light, as well as allow different tension springs depending on the boost application of your choice. All the necessary installation parts come with this kit, including install instructions. This kit installation is very similar to Forge's diverter valve kit installation. You must insert your vacuum block in the intake manifold hose, run all of your vacuum lines to the vacuum solenoid and to the valve itself, and connect the vacuum solenoid to the stock wiring harness. The only difference between the two installations is instead of installing Forge's diverter valve, we installed Forge's blowout valve. Now that you've learned how to install these valves, I'm going to give you a little bit more insight on how they work and what purpose they serve. What we have here is a stock turbo off a 2-liter turbo engine, an OEM diverter valve, a Forge vacuum-operated diverter valve, and a Forge vacuum-operated blowout valve. We're going to start with a diverter valve. A recirculating valve, or also known as a diverter valve, is meant to release boost when you're off the throttle. This keeps the turbo spooled up between shifts and decreases the amount of time it takes to build up full boost. When you're off the throttle, the engine sees vacuum and pulls back the piston to send your boost back into the inlet of the turbo. As soon as you're on the throttle again, it quickly closes and allows you to build boost pressure. Even though your OEM diverter valve is ECU controlled and the Forge is vacuum controlled, they still serve the same general purpose of allowing the air to recirculate back into the inlet of the turbo. A blowout valve, on the other hand, blocks the passageway to the recirculation pipe and allows the air to flow freely into the atmosphere. What we've done for you today is install a microphone under the hood of our 2010 Volkswagen GTI to show you the different sounds each valve makes. Well, we've shown you how these valves are installed, how they work, and the different sounds they make. I'm Mike with ECS Tuning, and I'll see you next time.